Well, hello, everybody. Praise the Lord. I just wanted to talk about Daughters of the King. We've had an amazing, amazing, amazing time this year. The year's not over, but I'm so grateful for Daughters of the King. And we're just, I brought on my beautiful guest, Prophetess Regina, on to be with me. We're just going to talk about Daughters of the King and, you know, just how it has touched her life. And so before we get into that, I just wanted to talk, ladies, we have actually moved the date for the Daughters of the King, formerly known as Sisters Day with Tanya. We moved the trip to go see Queen Esther to next year, April 17th of 2021. With everything going on, we want it to be safe. We want everyone to enjoy themselves. You all know how I am. I love a sisterhood. I love fellowship. And I want us to experience it in a healthy, healthy way where we don't have to be 6 feet apart and things of that nature. And just because of all of the travel restrictions and things like that, with you in mind, we moved it. All right. And so we're still going to see Queen Esther. If you would like to go with us, you can go on the Kingdom Advances page. You can go to events and you can register. All right. Yes. You can do a partial payment and or you can do a full payment. All right. But you will get an invoice and things of that nature. Everything we do is just done in integrity. And so we're grateful for that. But please, if you would love to join us, we'd be more than happy to have you. Amen.
Amen.
So, Prophetess Regina, what is up, girl?
Hanging in. Praise the Lord.
Hey. I met Prophetess Regina like from one of my random lives that I did.
Yes.
And she popped in a couple times, and then we would like message each other sometimes.
Amen.
And so, you know, I started this group. It was Sisters Day with Tanya. We changed the name in, I believe, like April or something of that nature to Daughters of the King.
Awesome.
And in January, we did a fast for mankind. We were believing God. If you believe in God for your marriage, to be married, for the men in your lives, just for mankind. And we prayed from the book, The Power of a Praying Wife, back in January. Yes. And in, I think, June, I did, the Lord told me to do another 31 days of prayer. When we did it in January, it was at noon every day for 31 mm-hmm. days. People, the testimonies poured in. People are still getting blessed by that. And then in June, the Lord told me to do another 31 days of prayer with women. And I invited Prophetess Regina to join the group at that time.
Amen.
So if you could just talk about your experience with the group, I know you got some stuff.
Yes, it is just a blessing that you're allowing me to come on and be with you today. I'm so grateful. Grateful that the Lord allowed our paths to cross. As we know, there's many people on Facebook, okay? And you got prophet this, apostle this. But when I came across your teachings and your exhortations for in the morning, it just blessed my soul to see someone truly sold out for God and the ability for you to pick up somebody's name and just go. I was like, okay, she on 10. I never seen that. Before it's usually kind of throwing something out, somebody on the line with a headache or some, but you just hit it up and just not only did you give a word, but it was a noun word. It was right what I needed at the time because I was in some transition. Major things were happening in my life and not really in a place where I was allowing people to speak because some people don't have wisdom and, some people are trying to impress and sometimes we are zealous without wisdom. And so I had crossed those paths a lot of times, but when I came across you, I just knew, I said, this is a genuine woman of God who cares for people, will pour out, and then she's my shouting chick. I was like, oh yes, I got a shouter with me. I love to praise the Lord. Wouldn't shame to give your God praise and just get caught up in 2.5 seconds to get to the room. I'm like, that's my girl. Yes, that's my girl. And so when you invited me to the Daughters of the King, I was facing something major. I needed to make a major decision. And you so happened to say, listen, I want you to join this group. And so I said, okay, God. She don't seem like she don't play no game. So, and you hadn't been saying that word. And then I know you really don't play no games. I said, she don't seem straightforward and she don't play no game. So I'm going to go and be a part of it. And I just look forward to every morning. I felt like it was the crank pumped up praise party that you can have with a whole lot of women you don't know, exhorting each other, genuinely caring for each other. When you release a word of encouragement on any one of us, everybody's clapping, everybody's shouting, everybody's saying the same thing. And I just was like, Lord, this is real. Like, we can really be women who love God, who are not jealous of each other, who know who we are in God, and we can collectively come together and have a corporate anointing over Facebook. God, you're doing some awesome things. Listen, because I miss shouting in church, you know, but I was like, this is intimate. I am an intimate person. I like intimate worship. I like genuine worship. I don't do the fake pump and prime. I've been there, done that, came out of denomination, know all about it. I know when to shout, turn around, hit your neighbor, sit it back down, get back up, okay? So been there, but to have women that you have never met, and you would think we all know each other. You think we go down the street, we go to church together. We're saying, hey girl, how you doing? How's the kids doing? How's mom? Whatever a situation was that was weighing on any of us, everybody was asking, how are you doing? Or we're giving praise reports and everybody is congratulating and praising God and thanking God. And even when we were weak, even when we were weak and we were vulnerable and we were just having a day, we didn't feel it. There were many days I got up, I didn't feel it. And God was teaching me, it's not about emotion in this season. You got to know. And I will put you in a place with women who can uphold you as they did for Moses, like an Aaron in your life, to help pull you up. That is the most precious thing that you can experience from Abba, where he would extend his hands and put you in a place that was safe. It was safe. And you were so transparent, so real, but you didn't play no games. And you set standard. You let us know we're going to be integrists. We're going to do things the right way. You know, whatever we discuss, when I say this don't go anywhere, it didn't go anywhere. I mean, that's you right. Made sure that this is about God's business. And we will cover each other. We will cover each other. We're going to uplift each other. And I'm saying, my God, where she get all this energy from at 6 a.m.? Like, I thought I was the only one, but I mean, maybe a few days I was like, I'm going to see how this going to work out. Let me see if she, but you press, if it was 3 on the line, if it was 4 on the line, see, it did not matter. You woke up already with your worship music or praise music, whatever the Lord had given unto you, and you just came out the gateway. I knew you were, sometimes I'm pretty sure you were tired. I'm pretty sure you have your own life. You have your own things going on. Your your ministry, your husband in ministry, you're a mom, you're a businesswoman, but you give it all that you have. And so I am just blessed to be in your presence. I can't wait until we meet, because I feel like you're my big sister. I talk about you to everybody. You would think I'm like, y'all gotta meet my sister from up north, honey. Cause she don't play.
I love you. I mean, and what I love the most is whatever the Lord tells me to do is what I do. And I am not like a morning person like that. And he was like, I mean, literally, whatever time he gave me. So January, he said noon. Every day at noon, we met. Every single day. Wow. And then in July, he said 6 a.m. And I was like, what? Hold up, Jesus. Hold on a second. But you know, God was waiting. And, you know, I told my husband, I was like, God said every day for the month of July, I need to pray. We need to come together and pray and at 6 a.m. Amen. And so, you know, at that point, it didn't matter to me. Every day at 6 a.m., I just gave what he told me to do. I just did. I love it because, you know, I think it had been missing the and I'm not putting this on me, but the authenticity of what the church should be, man. Come on. I know what you're saying. I've been in ministry for over 25 years. You know, you see a lot of things that are not of God. And you know, it's like how can you reach the lost? How can you reach people who are truly searching for God if you're playing a bunch of games and you can't do it? You know, you just don't make a mockery of the things of God. And, you know, the daughters of the king is over like 300 some women. Yeah. I don't know, it might be more now. But I'm so grateful because we could come together. We would laugh. We would cry. Like we would be telling stories. You know, people be in the comments prophesying. I mean, prayer. I mean, it was so.
Amen.
I mean, people from all over the world, you know, were coming in to this live. Some places it was like 3 a.m. in the morning. I don't know, but California, all over. And to come together for the sole purpose to meet God, seek God, to hear what heaven had to say. I mean, come on, right?
Amen. That was amazing.
It was amazing. And I look forward to it. People are still dropping testimonies. You know, if someone says, you know, I lost a loved one, like my family. It is so beautiful. And to see everybody growing in their gifts or if they need assistance or whatever. But again, it was a safe or is a very safe place.
Amen.
Amen. And congratulations on your new platform. Hey,
Lord. Hey, what you doing? Hey.
And you know my favorite saying is miss me.
Miss me, devil. Miss me. Miss me. And then you get real cropped up. Miss me.
Yeah, but we would praise, we would worship, we would cry, you know, I feel like I always say this, like, I feel like I know you, but I know it's by the Spirit of God. You know, you'll know them by the fruit they bear and you'll know them by the Spirit of God. Amen. And so I am grateful to know you. I am just, can you just talk, not a whole lot, but maybe just, I know you mentioned like, how did you feel? You know, I know you talked about me, but I mean, just the sisterhood. And you've met some friends through this group too, right?
Yes, I have. For me, it was so good to see transparency. That is something that the Lord has given unto me. I have my own personal ministry called Recovery Room. And the Lord gave me that. And when he gave me that name, I said, that sounds like addiction and problems. He said, that's what they are. The problems. He said, and transparency is going to heal, Regina. It's going to heal. And to get with a set of women who just naked and not ashamed, naked and not ashamed, and you would just allow us to just get it out. Just to get it out. It was safe. You didn't judge anybody. So I felt so free in that even there were times I just laid there because, you know, I'm recovering. I had a broken foot and then I had my knee surgery. So I couldn't get up and really walk the floor like I wanted to and really press in some days. But just to read that, I would prop my phone up so I could just read the comments and you would chime in. If you know, as the Spirit of the Lord would lead you and just encourage and cut stuff off. No, that is not going to happen. That is not your destiny. You gave us wisdom. You gave us guidance. I mean, in that session, I felt like you were a true midwife. Midwife. A midwife is going to tell you about your posture. She's going to tell you when to bear down. She's going to tell you, oh, wait a minute, that's false. That ain't real. Come on. You know, that's it's not time to really push it. Just get in position, but you can't get off this birthing chair now. You got to stay on here. So I just really, for me, it took my faith to another level. It encouraged my heart. Just like you said, we still are encouraging each other. I will post things in the group and I go on there. I mean, I'm like, I'm late. Let me see what happened. Everybody's giving updates and what's going on in their lives. And just so good to see. And like I said, we all think we're sisters. So you would think we're down the street on inboxing where you located, where you are. Maybe we could get together and, just a blessing, such a blessing. My life has been forever changed. And I know people say that, but seriously, this saved my life in some areas.
My God, it saved my life.
You think the Lord gives you a simple thing, get up at 6 a.m. But you don't know what that 6 a.m. is, because when you do it, he puts out the clarion call for those who need it. And so it's so important that we are obedient to the Spirit of God, because there is so much to our obedience. There are so many people attached to the obedience, not just for ourselves, but it's so many other people. And just your sacrifice was just unbelievable. And even when you shared about your nephew, and I know that was a very touching Sunday, I'll never forget that Sunday morning, and you shared, and I can tell you were tired. But then you flew out the chair, say, hold on, let me get a praise in. I'll be right back. I said, Lord, this lady here. This woman here is going to push in a praise. She going to push in a hallelujah. And we'll leave you. You better catch me while you can. And I was like, I wish I was in the bed like this. I was in there like, Father, we thank you. You know, we just thank God, you know, even, you know, you're being open and, you know, transparent about things, and us seeing you being a real woman of God, us seeing you navigate, you know, through those terrains. I mean, who, you know, you didn't know you were going to have to go through that, but that didn't stop your assignment. It didn't stop your fervency. It didn't stop your perseverance to make sure you were on, and you were on every day. You didn't
say, well, we come in sometimes. I mean, the Spirit of God would be like, boom. I mean, we would like
Jesus.
And let me just say, we were reading, we were praying at 6 a.m., but we were reading the book of Proverbs every day.
Every day.
So in January, we did 31 prayers for the men, but in July, God said to read the book of Proverbs. 31 days, you know, it's 31 Proverbs, and to read Proverbs every day. So some days, man, I mean, we come in and it was like a rocket, because it was
amazing.
I mean, God was meeting us. God was like, yes, like somebody answering that, like they get it. And he was like, come on in. And man, we were going. Some mornings we wouldn't even, I don't even know if the music would get going yet. We were just,
we was going.
I mean, we were there. I mean, God was meeting us every single day. And then to read the book of wisdom, it was like, that word was cutting. The word of God is truly like a two-edged sword.
Yes.
It was cutting us, but it was for our good. You know, the word of God is for our good. And so I'm so excited. Y'all know. And then we had like certificates at the end of the 31 days.
We did. They were amazing. I was like, she's gonna give us certificates. All right, God, this is cool.
Oh my gosh. And amazing. I remember near the last week, it was like all these platforms. Like I could see all these platforms. Congratulations on your new platform. Ooh. I don't know how many times I said that.
Man, I tell you, till it got into our spirits, till it got in the inside.
And I tell you, I mean, to have you on here with me today, it's such an honor for me because I love you dearly. Like, you are so beautiful, you know. And what I know, one thing I know for sure is that the enemy would love to kill the gifts of God within us, especially prophets. Like, it's just a hit out, well, had been a hit out on prophets. And so, you know, I love that. Amen. It was like that gift could not die in you. Like, you have so much in you to give to women and the world. And so I'm so grateful. Honored, because the enemy wanted to kill that gift.
Oh gosh. Oh yeah.
And recovery room, like, come on. It's like, what? No, we ain't doing that.
Okay. Yes. I paid for that.
Had young women, women middle age, we had older in the group. Like, it's the gamut. It's not one age group. You know, it's young women. It to come together with so many people who just love God.
My God.
I can't even imagine. Well, I can. I've seen parts of heaven, but heaven is amazing.
Woo-hoo. My God, when we all get together.
All ethnicities. It wasn't one ethnicity. Amen. You know, it was actually beautiful. It was so beautiful to be with daughters of the King.
Daughters of the King, yes.
Daughters of the King, man. We are daughters of the King. I tell you, we are daughters of the King. And we always kept it very integral. We still do.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
And ladies, I know you're going to see this and be like, where's Miss Tanya? I am on a social media fast. So, you know, I'm posting and not going in. But I have a time frame, but I am so happy. And I have another assignment coming up, ladies, in November. So I'll come back into the group. It's one day and we have to do something specific, but I won't release all the details until right before, maybe like a couple days before. We have an assignment, women of God. And one thing I love is that we're praying women. You know, we weren't just coming together. You're talking about praying women.
We were praying, pulling down. Yes.
Hannah's and Esther's and Deborah's.
Come on. Woo! My God.
Prophets and teachers and evangelists and pastors and apostles and just people. Amen. The body of Christ coming together. I mean, the joy from that, and just sharing our love and our hearts with one another and just lifting up one another, man, I tell you, it is like, it's the most precious thing to me, because I love to see people fulfilling their assignment in the earth. Like, for me, that's like, man, what do you see? Come on. What is it? Come on, get it. Come on, God. It's something in you. God gives good gifts. He gives good and perfect gifts. So it's something in there. We just got to crack that box, you know? What's in that alabaster box, daughter of the King?
My God.
What is in your alabaster box? Yes, glory to God. Because some people don't know the cost of the oil. My God. They don't know the cost.
It costs.
They don't know the cost. And they don't know the cost of your oil.
It's going to cost you everything. Everything.
Everything. But I tell you, to know that we can lift one another up.
Even
when it hurts.
My God.
Yes. Even when it's painful. It's like, oh no, you're going to make it. Come on. Oh, wait a minute. You need some help? Okay, I got this leg.
Yes.
Yes. I'm gonna put a bandage on that. We're gonna wrap that thing up.
Come on.
We're gonna get you healed.
Yes.
And keep it moving.
Keep it moving. Amen.
What? You don't know time? Okay. Well, we speak strength to you today.
Speak strength to you. Absolutely. And
you said today you need some joy. You need to put on a garment of praise for a spirit of heaviness. I mean, we were literally just the word. And I'm so grateful.
Amen.
For you. I really wanted to have your story because, you know, when people have tried to smother your voice, tried to take your voice, tried to take what the gift of God within you, tried to control it, manipulate it. And yes, I know what I'm saying, by the Spirit of God, just tried to destroy the very gift of God in you. It can be a very demeaning thing naturally.
Yes.
It can be very demeaning, and it's just not
that.
And so I am grateful for you. I am so happy to see,
praise,
you know,
God,
where you are, to see where you're going, and just the life, literally like the life come back into you, you know. Just your whole countenance has changed, and I'm so forever grateful.
Amen. Amen. If I could say two pivotal things that really blessed me. Number one, we need to give a shout out to DJ Wanda, because she was on DJ Wanda. DJ Wanda had them songs. Let me tell you, she was great. I had to Google stuff like, well, where she found this with that? DJ Wanda, and I used them songs in the midnight. In the midnight hour, I will put those songs on. You've been so faithful. I played that to the ground. I was singing that in my choir version. You've been so faithful. And even in the midnight, God really began, before you would release anything, God started toward the end, waking me up about 3 a.m. And when the Lord deals with me, I just write. I can just hear and I write. I just write. Most of the time I don't read it right away because it's 3 or 4 a.m. and I will put it up. I have a prophetic book. I'll put it up, and then I went back to sleep. And one morning you begin to release the word over me. You told me to do a dress rehearsal. And I was like, okay, now she's going to the left. This is different. The dress rehearsal. I haven't worn makeup in like forever, God. I don't even know what to do, because we were just kind of in a stuck mode, and you gave me that charge to do it. And then I made excuse about it. The next morning you said, you know, did you do your dress rehearsal? No, ma'am, I didn't do it. I'm going to do it today. And so the Lord reminded me, he says, go back in your book and verbatim. Right there, 3 a.m. I put 3 a.m. to 6 a.m. the same word. I didn't even read it, or what God was saying. And he used you just to echo it again. Like, this is an urgency. You got to dust off. No matter what's going on in the world, no matter what chaos is, I need my people to dust off, because we just got complacent. We can just tell the truth. We got complacent. He said, I had to send, you know, again, that clarion call to tell you, get up. You still got work to do. It's not over. You got work. I know how to navigate through COVID. That ain't my issue. But I need you to line up, and you would just, you know, just continue to push it. You will go on about something else and it'll come back to you, and you'll say, listen, I know what I hear. And I just honored the Lord. I honored him that you will be so sensitive to just me. You know, we don't know each other, but you will be sensitive. If I inboxed you something, you will lift it before the Lord. You were willing to fast with me. I'm like, this lady is rare, okay? Because most of the time, you know, the good great prophets would tell you to go ahead on and fast, and we're just going to believe the Lord with you. But you would do it with us. It's like you again, that midwife, I'll get in a gutter with you, because I know what God will do. I've been there. And it's if you had a part of you in all of us, like you could recognize, like most of what we all were going through, whether it was loss, whether it was, you know, facing a major decision or being rejected by a church, which was huge. you know, by church people because you're different. Your anointing doesn't fit the mold. You don't fit in. You don't look like this one. You know, I'm trying to fit you in the word and you coming sideways. You didn't do it the way we did it. You didn't serve like we serve. And how do you know so much wisdom? And how do you know so much this? And I just shelled in and said, like, why am I anointed? God, why did you call me? Like, you know, you get into that shell where you had that drive and it was still there, but it was quiet. And it's like you came in like that warrior said, uh-uh, baby, let's go. Let me ignite that fire. There is no way you're going to lay down on this. You cannot afford to. It's too much in you. It's too much. And so the church needs more of that teaching and that edification in the works. You are a servant leader. You're not a leader servant. You are a servant leader. You have to be a servant leader. How are we going to follow signs, miracles, and wonders if you ain't serving? Oh, we're going to let that go. Okay.
No, you know what I love is because we're both very seasoned individuals in the church and being in, you know, in, I want to call that part Christianity because it really wasn't the kingdom of God because the kingdom of God operates completely different.
Absolutely.
You know, and it's the truth. It's the truth, whether somebody likes it or not, it's the truth.
It's the truth.
And, you know, I remember one day we were in there and it was like, I was talking about your voice, like, yes. speak up. I mean, it was just like,
absolutely.
Don't you close your mouth, speak up. I mean, it was like, that's all I kept saying. Amen. And it was like, speak up, daughter, speak up. I mean, it was like, no, don't you shut your mouth. No, your voice is needed. You know, it was just like, until it was like, just speak up, get up. And so whoever is listening to this, if you're not a part of the group and you would like to be, you can ask to be a part of Daughters of the King. But if you don't even come in, because this is going to be on Kingdom Advances page, get up, daughter. Whatever you can say to a woman, Prophetess Regina, who just speak a word over someone, because I know you keep the word of the Lord in your mouth. Wow. I know you do. You do.
My God, I would say to her is to be what Christ has called you to be. You are an original design. You're not going to have the blueprint of anybody else. And the thing that the Lord told me is you just need to settle it with yourself because I choose who I choose. Mm-hmm. I put my anointing on who I put my anointing on. You can never explain your favor. You can never explain your gift. You can never explain it. So stop trying to explain it. Stop trying to justify why he called you before the foundations of the earth. You had nothing to do with it. He chose you. You didn't choose him. It is what it is. And the thing about it, you're going to be marked. You're going to be marked wherever you go. When you forget who you are, God will send a prophetess, Tanya. He will send anybody to remind you, I can see the mark of the Lord on your life. I see the mark of the Lord. So you can run from it, but it's never going to be erased. It will never be erased because then he will never be God. He cannot lie. He cannot go against his word. He chooses who he chooses. Just come from out of that. You cannot explain who you are. And those people that are coming against you don't know who they are. They don't know who they are. They know their gift, but they don't know who they are. And when they see something unique, they see something rare, they see something that does not fit the church, it becomes an issue. But you have to be who God called you to be. You will never fulfill, you will never have your voids filled, you will never be in a place of joy, not happiness. Happiness is temporary, joy is eternal. You will never feel fulfilled, you will never feel like you're part of anything until you just line up and be who he called you to be.
My God. I'm very stirred, but I'm trying to hold myself.
Amen.
I'm trying to really hold myself because that is our scripture. And it is 1 Peter 2 and 9.
My God.
You're a peculiar people. You know, you're God calls us a royal priesthood, a holy nation. And so what you were speaking to is literally the scripture that is for our ministry, and wow, that you're different. God made each, and listen, each and every one of us are so unique that He knows the very hairs on your head. He knows your fingerprint. There's no one else like you.
Nope.
And so we just wanted to, as women of God, glory to God, as daughters of the King, we want you to know the same thing. Hallelujah. God is no respecter of persons.
No.
He's no respecter of
persons. There is no favoritism in the kingdom.
Come on.
Boom. There is no favoritism in the kingdom. He is not a respecter. Peter said, I perceive that he is not a respecter of person when he went to the Gentiles. There is no favoritism in the kingdom. We all just have different assignments, different mantles, but there is no favoritism. He loves us all the same. All the same. You finna make me go into something else. We better let that go.
I'm trying to tell you, I know when you get two problems together, it's off the hook.
Yeah.
Because you get so stirred. But I just want you all to know. And if you know someone who doesn't, you know, hasn't had this type of you need someone, you need a safe place to be healed. Mm-hmm. You know, everybody can't come in when you're being healed.
Oof.
Remember when Jesus went to the child, when the guy came to him and he said, Jesus, yes, my son died. And Jesus said, all right, everybody out. Shut the door.
Yes.
Shut the door. My God.
Everybody can't be a part of your door.
Hallelujah.
Everybody cannot be a part
of your healing. Everybody can't be a part of your recovery. Everybody can't be a part of your deliverance. Glory to God. But I tell you what, the people that are in the room, my gosh, the ones who will make sure that you got everything you need. Hallelujah. If you need some, you know, you need some more air, you need some oxygen.
Yes.
I'm not even a doctor.
A respiratory therapist. You'll get a nurse. You'll get a doctor. You'll get an occupational therapist if you need it. Yes. Everybody needs to be skilled, qualified, and anointed and appointed and have had tried. Been tried. They've been tried.
Listen, you need a blood transfusion. Hey, you need a blood transfusion. You need an IV. What you need?
Listen, what you need? We got it. What you
need? Ooh, we got it. We got it. And so,
everybody
can't. My gosh. Everybody can have. I'm getting stirred, y'all. So just when I get like this, if you ever met me, you already know. But I'm getting so stirred because everybody cannot be a part of what God is doing. And so what I love is that we can come together, you know, we can love each other, and that you can be healed. You can, you know, because it's been people that have been in the group and it's like, wait a minute, I know God like this, you know? And so it's a beautiful thing that they're coming to know God. They're starting to serve God. They sold out for God. They are like, oh, nah, I'm rededicating my life today. You know, like, oh, no, I repent. Like, you got a group coming in, people repenting. Like,
hallelujah.
That, man, people's lives are being changed.
Amen.
You know, because the biggest part is a life that's changed.
Amen. Amen.
That's why Jesus came, man. He didn't come. He came to set the captives free. He came to change your life.
Yes, he did.
When you have an encounter with God, something happens. Things change when you have an encounter. You can look throughout scripture. Man, when Jesus came on the scene, something happened. People changed.
Amen.
Then he said, I'm going to go back and tell. It's like, how can you not tell of the goodness of God? It's like, wait a minute, do you understand what just happened to me?
Absolutely. Yes.
And that's how we should be witnesses. Amen. Because it's like, wait a minute. I gotta tell you, I used to be dirty. Now I'm clean. Ooh. But I didn't clean myself up. Jesus cleaned me up. I couldn't have did this by myself. And so it's like, I gotta tell it. I can't keep it to myself because he's been that good.
Thank you, Jesus.
He's been that good. Like, I can't keep this to myself.
Like Jeremiah said, it's like fire.
Fire.
Shut up
in our hearts.
I cannot.
I just thank you for your talking. I thank you for helping someone on today, some woman who needed to hear this message. And that's why I know, you know, God just had me to have you come on. And so we could share the testimony about change and what the, you know, what Daughters of the King. And yes, it's a closed group because just like she said, we want to make sure that people are safe. Amen. People are safe. You, when you're dealing with souls, you know, it is a precious, precious thing. Yes.
Oh my God.
And once we really grasp how precious a soul is, not what I look like on the outside, but my soul, is it well with your soul?
My God.
Is it well with your soul? So I'm grateful for you.
Amen.
I cannot wait to see the rest of the fruit from your life. I am going to be around for the party. I want to be at the table. I want to be at the table.
You come to recovery room.
In the presence of your enemies and all that good stuff. I got to be at the table. I got to be at that table. I am honored. Thank you for taking this time just to share your testimony, your story. And ladies, if you want to come in, you're more than welcome. And thank you, Prophetess Regina. That's what I call you. That's what God calls you.
Thank you, woman of God. Thank you. It's an honor. Thank you so much. Woo. I just feel his glory. We better get off this line.
I feel it too. That's why I'm sitting there like, my God. Eyes haven't seen nor have ears heard the good things that God is getting out of your life in this moment and the way that he's going to catapult you. And, you know, I've shared this privately with you. I've shared it with you one-on-one. I've shared it with you in the group. And now I am publicly decreeing and declaring it because it now needs to be publicly said that eyes have not seen.
My God.
The good things that God has prepared for you and your family. I am excited. Yes. I cannot wait. Yes. Congratulations on this new platform and many more. Glory to God.
Bless you.
I just thank God for recompense in your life.
We thank you. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
Because what the enemy meant for evil, God's getting the glory out of your life.
Amen. And I see it. Amen. There is plenty of testimony to come. So I thank the Lord. I thank him. I do.
I wish I could hug you, but
I know. I have it in my prayer. Think I say, Lord, I gotta go meet my friend. I need to see my friend. So prayerfully, the Lord, we will be able to get together sometime.
Amen. I'm honored to know you. Thank you for your time. Thank you all for listening to us. And thank you. If you want to join Daughters of the King, you're more than welcome to. God bless you all. Good night.
Night.